This tutorial shows you how to calculate the minimum required sample size for the Pearson correlation with SPSS. An a priori sample size calculation is done to minimize the beta error as a result of insufficient power. Or put another way, you want to minimize the chances of not being able to observe existing effects. In SPSS, go through Analyze, Power Analysis, Correlation, Pearson Product Moment. First, make sure that it says Estimate Sample Size, since that is what you want to calculate. Second, you can either enter a single power value or grid power values. If you have specific guidelines regarding power, you will choose single power value and enter the respective number here. For context, power equals 1 minus the beta error probability. Beta error is the type 2 error. In short, this means falsely retaining the null hypothesis. If you want to calculate sample sizes based on multiple power values or even a range, let's say from 0.8 to 0.95 in 0.05 steps, you can define that here as well. I will use a single power value of 0.95 and therefore have a 5% type 2 error probability. In some research fields, 0.8 is used here. This means you automatically accept a type 2 error of up to 20%. If you have power lower than 0.95, this usually calls for a reasonable justification. Third, you have to specify a Pearson correlation parameter. This can be a population correlation coefficient or taken from a similar study. If neither exists, you can use research field specific thresholds. If those are also non-existent, you can fall back to Cohen-92, a power primer, which shows three thresholds, 0.1, 0.3 and 0.5 for small, medium and large correlations. 4. The null value is a value that specifies the null hypothesis value of the correlation parameter to be tested. Usually 0 is fine here. 5. You can check the box to use a bias correction formula. This adjusts the correlation coefficient to account for the bias due to small sample sizes, typically with a Fisher's Z transformation. 6. You have to specify whether you are conducting a one-tailed or two-tailed Pearson correlation. Two-tailed means you cannot tell in advance whether your correlation might be positive or negative. If you can, however, select one-tailed. The final input parameter needed is the significance level, aka the alpha error probability, which is the probability of committing a type 1 error. In short, this is the probability of wrongly rejecting the null hypothesis. 5% is the typical convention, 1% is a bit more restrictive. A value above 5% should be avoided. Finally, hit OK to see the minimum number of observations needed to detect the presumed correlation with the predefined type 1 error probability and power. As a rule of thumb, a smaller correlation and a larger power require more observations than the other way around.